Jean-Charles Dalbin from Airbus. I work in the avionics software department, and I'm involved in automatic code generation and qualification particularly. And today I would like to show you how we have used ADA in our context and which benefit we got in this context. So the agenda, my presentation is in three parts. Firstly, I would like to show you, to give you an overview of the avionics context and particularly the qualified automatic code generation activity. Then I would like to give you just also an overview of our automatic code generator process development and the ADA usage in this context. And then I will give you also some information about enhancements that we plan with ADA and the ACG process development. Let's start now by Airbus system development overview. For in-house development, at the first level, system designer produce high-level requirement in textual way and also produce model. This slide show you that we have a model-based system engineering at Airbus and with an intensive use of modeling and simulation. And at system designer level, also they provide validation plan and also make some simulation on local desktop, local simulation desktop. Then at avionic product manufacturer with an internal activity, we provide hardware equipment and also we provide software and functional application. At this level, we made some hardware and software integration and software integration. And the test and simulation activity allow to test equipment and also make system integration on aircraft on ground, as we have called Iron Bird, it's aircraft zero. At Avionic and Simulation Product Center, we develop a large part of system, like flight control and flight warning. And also, we provide hardware equipment, figures. We produce 6,000 computer per year. And also we provide all the software for this computer. And we use a software process based on automatic code generation and qualified automatic code generation. And for that, Airbus has set up an organization and with a team dedicated to automatic code generation. And the idea is to provide custom automatic code generation for each software team, for each different needs, and to be able to adapt the tool and not the software, and not the opposite software to the tool. It's an Airbus innovation introduced by during A340 development. And as we know, automatic code generation allow to produce the code and avoid human error. And sometimes the amount of data to code by hand is not really possible in industrial approach, and like configuration data with a lot of data, it's not possible to write code by hand. So we use automatic code generator. Then also we have a process who allow to qualify this type of tool, and the qualification allow to reduce verification activity on software on the code source produced by the automatic code generator. And automatic code generator software tool, we have three main challenges in this context, in the Avionics context. Firstly, this is a qualification development, and we have to follow a rigorous process, same as embedded software, with a lot of verification activity. And we use ADA to help us in the development activity. And the life cycle also is very very large scale time, with average 5 years for the development, and we have to define and to use tool in accordance with these constraints, and open source, for example, with maintenance tools, it fits well in this context. And finally, the qualification credit that we can get by the use of this type of tool allow to reduce some verification activity on the embedded software. Now, I would like to show the automatic code generation process and the feedback. This slide shows the V-cycle, and I would like to focus on the left side of the V-cycle. And from the need coming from the embedded software team, we write textual requirement for the specification, who is high-level requirement but detailed. And then we design with STUD. We provide a static design with data and control flow. Then we use ADA with ADA 95 and 2005 also, just a subset with GNAPRO compiler for Solaris. And we have a customized tool to answer to the DO17AB. And also, we have developed some tool to check consistency or to verify coding rules. And with its homemade tools, qualified as verification tool. In the coding activity, we have several layers and several different verification activity associated. And at the first level, we made some functional verification on the main function of the ACG, developed from high level requirement. And we have also developed some high level component, like database management system or a specific template scripting language to allow to customize output of the automatic code generator. At other level, we have also developed an internal common basic component with a unit verification based on the design. And then at the lower level, we use ADA runtime library as all users use ADA. But in the scope of the DO17AB, we have to be careful with the use of this type of library. We have to demonstrate that our process that we have set up, our verification process, allow to detect a problem, an error in this type of library. And we have also to identify and to analyze which services of the library that we used, and to know the errors on this product. So this slide is just to highlight that we have to balance with the use of external product in our context, and to be careful, because it's very interesting to use external library, but to avoid to rebuilding the wall. So we have also to demonstrate that we master this external component. This slide should give some examples that of feature of ADA language that we have used in our context, and we would like to focus on three main three main challenge with that we have to face in DO and CERN-AB. We have to track and to produce robust tool, and to avoid and to be able to avoid error when the input model is not correct. For that, we use exception mechanism, etc. In terms of safety, we have to have a tool completely determinist, and so we use initialization and other features that allow to avoid unexpected behavior. And then to ease verification, we avoid features that that could be difficult to verify. So we could say that ADA is interesting on three points of view. Firstly, in terms of programming, clearly it is development by the reusable component that we have developed, and also with the possibility with compiler check, and also the verification activities is with a language formally defined who help reviewing code and analysis, and also ADA is well known for this strong typing properties. And in terms of compiler and maintenance policy on long-term view, open source is interesting, and we think we have the choice of the support services, and we have the choice to change something in this context without too many constraints. And the main fact that we have with using ADA is the certification authority confidence. Our feedback on this on automatic code generation is we have qualified 80 tools in the scope of the D117AB, and with a lot of a large number of lines of code in aircraft in services without problem report in services. ADA contribute to this in this success. The process DO17AB also for sure, but ADA is an important element in this scheming. Now, it's not the end of the story, and we still improve something. And we thought that it will be interesting to have a better iterative cycle between design and code for the automatic code generation. And it's a question of tooling. And we have looked at the tooling, and we would like to move on new technology and on open source technology. So on pilot project, we have used Eclipse and Topcase for the design, and we have developed some checks and automatic code generation with OCL and Axeleo also, and we used the documentation generator from Topcase, GenDoc, and we have set up a new framework as we have called ACG Designer, and it looks like as you at this picture. And on in the same environment, we have the design with UML edition, UML classes edition, with requirement traceability, documentation, code generation, and check rules, check-in rules, and with a positive feedback from the developer. So, for the future, we intend to still use ADA for qualified tools, and with a positive feedback on the pilot project, we wish to extend the use of the Eclipse and Topcase tool, and for all the activity of the V cycle, and we also support all the initiatives with UML and ADA in DO17AB context for the DO17AC qualified context also. That's all for the presentation. Thank you very much.